all there. So I will just pretend like I see you all, and you guys can participate just as you normally would with story time. I just won't be able to hear you sing and dance today. Okay, we're gonna get started. So let's stand up and we will do my favorite welcome song.
Hello everybody, glad to see you. Clap your hands and show you're glad to see me too. Clap your hands, everybody, clap your hands. Clap your hands and show you're glad to see me too.
Good to see you guys today. Our next song is a good morning song. It's called Good Day, and I brought some friends with me. So I wanted to let them come out and say hi to everybody. They're my farm animal friends. I thought since it's getting nice out, we are going to start seeing some animals out and about. So we've got these guys today. My first little friend. Here he is.
When cows get up in the morning, they always say good day. When cows get up in the morning, they always say good day.
All right, what does a cow say?
How they say good day. chickens get up in the morning, they always say good day. When chickens get up in the morning, they always say good day. They say,
quack, 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 quack.
That's how they say good day. They say,
quack, 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 quack.
The kids, what do you guys say?
You say,
you don't make animal sounds, do you?
Good morning, Dad. Let's try it.
When kids get up in the morning, they always say good day. When kids get up in the morning, they always say good day. They say, good morning, Mom. Good morning, Dad.
Later. Okay, so today I thought we would talk about spring and some of the things that happen in spring, like rain and sunshine and bunnies, because it's getting to be springtime. It's supposed to be really, really warm tomorrow. So our first book is called One Springy Singy Day. One Springy Singy Day. Here we go. Stretch, wide awake at dawnie. You're a springy lamb at play who can't wait to start the day. Blowy, mowy, up and on the goey. You're a busy, buzzy bee. 1, 2, 3, and A, B, C. Peachy, Perry, noodles in your hairy. It's like it's lunchtime. You conduct a little tune while you wave your fork and spoon. And maybe making a little bit of a mess there, huh? Clappy, flappy, singy, dancy, happy. You're a perfect shiny star. Make a wish and you'll go far. Crafty, brushy, time to be hushy, hushy. It's time to go to school, to go home. Oh, to the library. You choose your favorite story, or two, or three, or four-y. I know many of you like to get lots of books when you come to the library. Growy, toey, up high, and down lowy. You're the strongest power truck, rolling and raking through the muck. Soapy, scrubby, bubbles in the tubby. I think it's starting to become the end of the day. Taking a bath. You're all warm and fuzzy and clean when we start our night routine. Comfy, cozy, kiss your tiny nosy. We'll have fun tomorrow too. Sleepy, huggy, squeezy you. What a busy day they had. That's how every day is, doing so many things like going to school or going to the library, going to the store, to the park, eating lunch, and taking a bath. It's a busy day. Okay, let's get some little raindrops up here. You guys know the song Itsy Bitsy Spider, right? We're gonna sing a similar song to the same tune. I'm gonna bring the board over here and kind of move the camera a little so you guys can see it better. All right, we have five little raindrops dancing on the walk. Pitter patter, pitter patter, that's how they talk. Out comes the sun, shining bright in the sky, and away goes one raindrop, bye, bye, bye. Let's take one away. How many do we have left? One, two, three, four. Four little raindrops dancing on the walk. Pitter patter, pitter patter, that's how they talk. Out comes the sun, shining bright in the sky, and away goes one raindrop, bye, bye, bye. Let's take away one raindrop. How many do we have left? One, two, three. Three little raindrops dancing on the walk. Pitter patter, pitter patter, that's how they talk. Out comes the sun, shining bright in the sky, and away goes one raindrop, bye, bye, bye. How many are left? There's two. Two little raindrops dancing on the walk. Pitter patter, pitter patter, that's how they talk. Out comes the sun, bright in the sky, and away goes one raindrop, bye, bye, bye. How many are left? Just one. One little raindrop dancing on the walk. Pitter patter, pitter patter, that's how they talk. Out comes the sun, shining bright in the sky, and away goes one raindrop, bye, bye, bye. And that's it. Now we just have sunshine. And that's what happens. Sometimes it starts raining really hard with lots of raindrops, and then it gets slower and slower and slower till it stops. And that's when we get a nice sunny day with lots of growing flowers. Okay, here's our next story called Wee Little Bunny. Starting to see little bunnies all over the place in my yard. They're hopping around, chewing sticks and things like that. It was spring in the meadow, and the wee little bunny was all brand new. So a baby bunny. This wee little bunny was a busy little bunny. "What will you do today?" asked his sweet mama dear. "Everything," said the bunny, and run, 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 he chased a dragonfly. "Let's hide inside this log," said the stripy chipmunk brown. "Chase me first," called the bunny, and giggle, 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 he dashed through the grass. "Settle down now," grumped the prickly porcupine. I think porcupines are kind of grumpy, aren't they? "Sorry, sir," said the bunny, and tippy, tippy toe, he splashed across the brook. "Time to hop on home," sang the chickadee. "Soon," called the bunny, and wiggle, 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 he tumbled in the clover. Then the wee bunny heard mama call, "Story time!" And he scampered fast, 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 right to mama's side. "There's my busy, dizzy bunny," said mama with a tickle. "Won't you sit a little while and tell your busy tale?" "Oh, yes," said the bunny. Then snuggle, 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 he told a happy tale of his busy, dizzy day. The end. So it's just like when you come home from visiting a friend or going to school and you tell your mom and dad all about what you did. It's so much fun to tell the story again. Okay, now we have a little bunny song. So everybody can stand up. I'm gonna change the music real quick. And we're gonna do a little hopping bunny song. This is a counting song too. So we need to have some help counting to five today. All right, here we go. We're gonna start with, on my board here, one little bunny. All right, here we go.
Okay. One little bunny hopping on the floor.
Ready, let's hop.
She heard a knock-knocking, at the door. So she hopped on over and opened it up, and another little bunny came in to hop. How many bunnies are there now?
Two. Ready?
Two little bunnies hopping on the floor. When they heard a knock-knocking at the door. So they hopped on over and opened it up, and another little bunny came in to pop.
How many
bunnies are there now?
Three.
Three little bunnies hopping on the floor. When they heard a knock-knocking at the door. So they hopped on over and opened it up,
for a minute. For our next story is called The Mushroom in the Rain. Now, I'm going to tell this one as a flannel story and not a book. One day, my little ant friend, he's very tiny, was caught in the rain. Where can I hide? He wondered. So he saw a tiny mushroom peeking out of the ground in a clearing, and he hid underneath it. He sat there waiting for the rain to stop. I'm gonna put him there. I know he's a little hard to see because he's pretty small. But the rain came down harder and harder. Suddenly, a wet butterfly crawled up to the mushroom. Cousin Ant, can you let me in from the rain? I am so wet I cannot fly. How can I let you in? Said the ant. There's barely enough room for one. It does not matter, said the butterfly. Better crowded than wet. So they scooted over, and now they're both underneath that mushroom. A mouse ran up. Let me hide under the mushroom. I am drenched to the bone. How can we let you in? There is no more room here. Just move a little closer. So they huddled in underneath the mushroom. There they all are. The rain came down harder and harder, and it would not stop. And a little sparrow flew over and hopped up to the mushroom crying, my feathers are dripping, my wings are so wet and tired, I can't fly. Let me in the mushroom to dry out and rest until the rain stops. But there's no room in here. Please move over just a little. So they all moved over and crowded underneath the mushroom. Look at all of them under there, hiding under that mushroom. Then a rabbit hopped in from the clearing and saw the mushroom. Oh, hide me, he cried. Save me, a fox is chasing me. Poor rabbit, said the ant. Let's crowd ourselves a little more and take him in. So they all moved over and they crowded underneath the mushroom and they let him in. Oh my gosh, how many animals can you get underneath a mushroom? The fox came near and he sniffed. There is a rabbit smell around here. Is he hiding in here? You silly fox, how could a rabbit get in here? Don't you see there isn't any room? The fox turned up his nose, flicked his tail, and ran off. By then, the rain was over and the sun looked out from behind the clouds and everyone came out from the mushroom, bright and merry. The ant looked at his neighbors. How could this be? First, I had hardly any room under the mushroom for myself, and in the end, all five of us were able to sit under this mushroom. Huh, that's pretty weird. It's like a lot of room for them now. Ha ha ha, somebody laughed loudly behind them. They turned and they saw a fat green frog sitting on top of the mushroom, shaking his head at them. Ha ha ha, said the frog again. Don't you know what happens to a mushroom in the rain? And he hopped away, still laughing. The ant, the butterfly, the sparrow, and the rabbit, and the mouse looked at one another and then at the mushroom, and they suddenly knew why there was room enough under the mushroom for all of them. Do you know? Can you guess? What happens to a mushroom when it rains? It grows. It became this little mushroom, became this big mushroom. And that's what happens to all the plants when it rains. You should start noticing, look at the grass in your yard or at the park and see that it's all brown right now. And as soon as it rains a lot, it's gonna turn green. And all the flowers are gonna bloom and the trees are gonna bloom. It happens after just one rain. All right, you guys are doing awesome. We are going to take out our shakers. All right, if you have a shaker or something that you can use as a shaker, an instrument, a box of noodles or rice would work, or anything that makes a shaky sound, a baby rattle, if you have a baby brother or sister, that would work too. All right, let me change our music real quick. Here we go. This one is called 1, 2, 3, We. Ready? Today. Thank you for coming. We are going to finish off with the goodnight song. So if you have your own stuffy you want to bring, a stuffed animal or a doll or your own real pet even, you can go get them now and bring them back and they can sing the goodnight song with us. I know some of you already plan ahead and bring your stuffed animals with you before story time even starts, which is awesome. Have a great day, everyone. Thank you all for coming, and we will see you soon. Bye-bye.